Hello and welcome to our Christmas service for Airedales Hospitals Trust. As you can imagine, we're not able to gather in the chapel as we might have done in the past, but we won't let restrictions stop us from celebrating Christ's birth. So if you can't get to church this year, let church come to you through this service. And through the magic of the internet, we can be together, we can stay safe and share in the hope and joy of the Christmas message. So whether you're a patient or a member of staff or a visitor, welcome. I'm Liz Maitland, I'm the lead chaplain here, and I've prepared a short service for us to share with some readings and prayers. And we finished off with a medley of carols from the Airedale Hospital Choir, so I'm glad you're able to join me. We begin by thinking about light. Remember that Jesus, the light of the world, came into the world to be our light. Sometimes the world can seem quite a dark place when our lives are challenging and our health is causing us some worries. But Jesus came to be a light for each of us to help brighten our way and bring us hope. So I wonder, what's causing you a bit of darkness today? And what are your hopes for Christmas and beyond? Well, for many years, the people of God looked forward to the birth of the Messiah. And here are some words, some familiar words from the prophet Isaiah found in the Old Testament. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. That promise of light and good things to come. Let's continue with prayer. Let's pray together. Lord Jesus, we thank you that when the world was dark, you came to bring light into our darkness. You came in the night to bring light into the lives of Mary and Joseph and all the people who were waiting. You come to us now, into our lives and into our world, bringing light to all people. We ask you now to accept this worship that we bring as we approach Christmas and think about Jesus's birth. Give us the eyes to see your light shining and the faith to hold on to the truth you bring, looking for signs of hope and love. Amen. Well, our readings, our Christmas readings, speak of journeys made, don't they? And I wonder what journeys you've made this year. Maybe you've managed to travel and see some family you haven't seen for a long time. Maybe you did make it on a holiday when that's been possible. Or maybe the furthest you've got to is a hospital appointment or just down the road to the shops. But journeys of all lengths have challenges and can sometimes turn out in quite unexpected ways. Sometimes when we set out, things don't turn out how we imagine. As I read these familiar words of the Christmas story from Luke's Gospel, think of the different experiences of journeys we hear. Do they go as planned? Were they planned at all? And how did those involved respond to the challenges that happened? I'm reading from Luke's Gospel. At that time, the Roman Emperor Augustus decreed that the census should be taken throughout the Roman Empire. This was the first census taken when Quirinius was governor of Syria. All the people returned to their own ancestral homes to register for the census. And because Joseph was a descendant of King David, he had to go to Bethlehem in Judea, David's ancient home. He travelled there from the village of Nazareth in Galilee. He took with him Mary, to whom he was engaged, who was now expecting a child. And while they were there, the time came for her baby to be born. She gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him snugly in strips of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no lodging available for them. That night, there were shepherds staying in the fields nearby, guarding their flocks of sheep. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared among them and the radiance of the Lord surrounded them. They were terrified, but the angel reassured them. "Don't be afraid," he said. I bring to you good news that will bring great joy to all people. The Saviour, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David. And you will recognise him by this sign. You will find him, a baby wrapped snugly in strips of cloth, lying in a manger. Suddenly, the angel was joined by a vast host of others, the armies of heaven, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in highest heaven, and peace on earth to those with whom God is pleased." When the angels returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off, and they found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. So whose journeys have we heard about? Mary and Joseph, of course. Well, that didn't really go to plan, did it? If you're listening on one of our maternity wards, you might very well be glad that your birth didn't end up in a barn or after a very long journey. Maybe if you're joining us from one of our other wards, you have memories of other significant journeys in your life. For the shepherds, it was a lot easier once they got over the shock of the angel visit. That wasn't how they were expecting their evening to go, though. You may also recall the part of the story we haven't heard today, the wise men who undertook huge journeys following a star to find a king and being surprised to find a baby born to a poor family. For each of us, as we journey towards Christmas, there are unknowns and the unexpected. Are you a bit of a planner? Do you like to have everything all sorted out with a list? Well, our Bible readings remind us that even the best laid plans can go awry. Yet even in all the muddle and the mess of the first Christmas, journeys, a pregnant teenager, no booking, a birth in a messy stable, excited shepherds, shocked wise men, amongst all this, God was there, very much there in human form as a baby, the light of the world. God came because there is darkness and muddle and need in our world. If it had all been fine, Jesus wouldn't have needed to be born. I wonder what your hopes and prayers are as we journey together towards Christmas. What darkness do you need God's light to shine into? What challenges are you finding as you move forward? Let's bring some of those thoughts to God in prayer. Let's pray together. God of light and love, be with those of us who are unwell today. Bring help and healing and hope. Help us to keep trusting in you. God of light and love, be with our staff at Airedale Hospital today, those we see and those who work behind the scenes. Bless them all, especially over this busy Christmas period. Thank you for all the skill and the care and the experience they bring. God of light and love, we pray for those we cannot see at this time, family and friends and people we care about. Keep them safe and happy, and thank you for love that reaches beyond boundaries of distance and for ways to keep in touch. God of light and love, we pray for people and places in our country and across the world where there are troubles and people cannot enjoy peace and safety. May your message of hope be heard, and may we learn to walk in the way of peace together. We pray in the name of Jesus, the Son of Peace. Amen. That's nearly bringing us to my parts of our service to get today. I just wanted to remind you that the chaplaincy team here at Airedale, we're here to support everyone, patients and staff, all year round. So if you really would like to chat to one of us or see one of us and you're currently a patient, please ask a member of staff and we'd be really happy to pop along and see you. Before we come to our bit from Airedale Choir, which is going to be wonderful to listen to and to look out for, you'll be able to see if you can spot anyone you know and places that you recognise. But before that, a Christmas blessing for everyone. Light of God, lead us. Power of God, hold us. Joy of God, heal us. Love of God, warm us. So may the joy of the angels and the eagerness of the shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the obedience of Joseph and Mary, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. So I really hope that wherever this short service finds you, at home or in hospital, you're able to find light and know love this Christmas time. A happy Christmas from me and from all the chaplaincy team here at Airedale Hospital.
Thank you. Huge thank you to the choir for your sterling efforts and for lifting people's spirits at Christmas. I appreciate just how much effort goes into this and how much of your personal time you all commit to doing this for the church. So thank you and Merry Christmas.